a second Labor minister has found themselves in hot water in less than a week. Meka Whaitiri has stepped aside as minister while an investigation is carried out into a staffing matter in her office. She was the customs minister and held associate responsibility in the areas of agriculture, forestry, local government and Crown Māori relations. Her portfolios will be reallocated while the investigation takes place. Last Friday, of course, Claire Caron lost her cabinet position after she failed to properly declare a meeting for a second time. Our political editor, Jane Patterson, joins us now from our parliamentary office. We have to stop meeting like this, Jane. This is the second conversation.
That's right.
In 6 nights. What's gone on here?
So we're not exactly sure yet of the exact details of what happened and what the investigation is into. But what I can say is there has certainly been talk around Parliament about a high turnover in Meka Whaitiri's office, a high staff turnover. And also we have been told that she is a difficult minister sometimes to work with. The other thing we understand is that this investigation relates to a single matter. But past that, we're not quite sure what ministerial services will be conducting that investigation, and once that is over, things may become a bit clearer about what that relates to specifically.
Jane, we discussed Claire Caron last Friday, very different circumstances last Friday. The Prime Minister held a stand-up. She answered lots and lots and lots of questions about it, albeit very late in the day. This afternoon, this was announced by a five-paragraph media statement, and that's it, is it?
It is, and I think that probably relates to the fact that it could end up being an employment matter,
right,
or that there is an employee of ministerial services involved. So the people employed in the office, and I imagine that that's the reason for the very limited comment on this particular one.
How much is this a problem for the Prime Minister? And interestingly, both Claire Caron and Meka Whaitiri are Labor MPs. People suggested that the coalition parties, particularly New Zealand First, may have some issues around whipping and discipline. These are Labor MPs.
That's right. This is a problem for the Prime Ministers. I can't remember when there have been two disciplinary matters in the space of less than a week in the same executive. So Meka Whaitiri is a minister outside of cabinet. So there's a perception, look, there in terms of just ministerial conduct. And we don't know whether Meka Whaitiri will end up staying a minister, of course, or whether she will end up having to resign from the executive. But it does create another problem for Ms Ardern if Meka Whaitiri does go, because it affects the gender balance, apart from any perception of ministerial conduct or otherwise. At the moment, there are 10 out of the 28 in the executive, and that's ministers inside and outside cabinet. 10 of those are women. If Meka Whaitiri goes, that's 9 out of 28. So that gender balance really starting to drop. And remember too, within that, one of those women used to be a cabinet minister, Claire Caron. She's now outside the executive. And I must say, John, with a week including Claire Caron, if we take in last Friday, Shane Jones is questioning the Prime Minister's judgment on appointing Chris Luxon to the Advisory Council. Low business confidence, and then the Labor camp report coming out. It has been a less than stellar week for Labor and the Prime Minister, and she will not be happy about this latest development at all.
Jane Patterson, our political editor, joining us live from the gallery office. Thanks very much indeed, Jane. We appreciate it. Just a small detail matter. Meka Whaitiri was Minister of Customs. Chris Faafoi will take that portfolio on, and she was associate in all those other portfolios. And the associate minister responsibilities will just go to the ministers until this is sorted one way or another.